the most news in the morning. CNN's American Morning, weekday, 6 a.m. Eastern.
Well, it happens almost every day of every year. People on the far right and the far left doing or saying something pretty off the wall. And we've profiled many of them here on American Morning with a segment we call Wingnuts of the Week.
And we have the wingnut identifier here with us now, John Avalon. He's got a new book out about this particular subject, and it's called What Else? Wingnuts, How the Lunatic Fringe is Hijacking America. He's here as always. Good to see you, young fella. How'd you get into wingnuts?
Well, I'll tell you what. I mean, I realized that there are many Americans who feel really frustrated about the way the extremes end up dominating our dialogue. They really have disproportionate influence. And when I talk about wingnuts, I'm talking about people on the far right and far left of the political spectrum. You know, these are the people, the professional partisans, the unhinged activists, the paranoid conspiracy theorists, the people who are always trying to divide rather than unite us. And they really have developed a disproportionate influence over our politics that ends up drowning out most folks in the middle. So I realized what we needed to do is start punching back, left and right, to try to stop this cycle, because they end up encouraging each other. And by calling out the extremes, maybe bring some balance and common sense back to American politics, because we haven't seen enough of it.
Yeah, and it seems lately things have been worse. I mean, is it just because we're in it that it seems that way? Is it always like this in Washington in terms of, you know, the partisan back and forth and, of course, those on the fringe that just really seem to be... I don't know. Raring to go lately.
Stirring the crazy pot. Yeah, you know, in researching this book, what you realize is that people have been selling the snake oil forever. You know, demagogues always do well in economic downturns. There are always people trying to sell anger at the other as a way of propping up profiting politically or personally. But what's different now is that they've never had this kind of platform before because of three things, I think. One, you've got the parties more polarized than ever before. So the power is more at the fringes than the center of both parties. In fact, the center is trying to be drummed out in some cases. It's called rhino hunting and dino hunting. Mm-hmm. Then you've got the increasingly partisan media. You've got media feeding into this spin cycle on really people of high-profile shows trying to stir up this anger and rally the troops. And then add to that the Internet, which has really created an echo chamber that's become an incubator of extremism in some places, a real way to really radicalize folks and gin up that anger all day long. And this has created a hyperpolarization, hyperpartisanship in our politics that I believe is really at risk of getting seriously out of control.
Okay, we can describe them all day long, but it would help us if you gave us some examples of what you're talking about.
But of course. So yes. two examples from Congress and two examples from the media. And these are just symbols of the larger symptom of what's going on here. In Congress, on the left, Alan Grayson, and on the right, Michelle Bachmann. And the reason I picked these two folks is they really have distinguished themselves by being people who play aggressively to their base. You know, Alan Grayson called himself the congressman with guts. And how does he define that? Well, he defines Republicans as the enemy of America. And then Michelle Bachmann, you know, first came to prominence in 08, questioning whether then-candidate Obama was anti-American, then calling him a tyrant since, and really playing to the base in a way that gins up anger and makes her a hero to the base. That's what this dynamic is doing. And then, of course, in media, you've got two very high-profile, talented broadcasters who nonetheless kind of make their reputation off stirring this pot, Glenn Beck and Keith Olbermann. And in this case, you know, you've got these folks who are, again, talented, funny, smart, but play to the base so aggressively, calling opponents racist, calling opponents, you know, any kind of attack you can do, all in an attempt to gin up ratings. And what's different now is, by trying to appeal to a narrow but intense audience share to get good ratings, politics ends up following their model rather than the old model of trying to bring people together. That ends up being the symptom of how wingnuts are hijacking our politics, trying to divide us instead of unite us.
And so in your opinion, what is the prescription for sort of taking back the center, as you call it?
I do believe we can take America back from the lunatic fringe. I think first thing we need to do, we need to declare our independence. And more Americans are doing this. Independents are the largest and fastest growing segment of the electorate. More and more people, especially generationally, are looking at the extremes and saying, I don't want to affiliate or associate myself with those. I want to determine the person, not the party.
All right. Aren't independents also increasingly determining elections more so than we've seen
they
before?
Absolutely are, as we saw in Massachusetts with Scott Brown, but not just in states like Massachusetts. Again, if independents could realize that there are more independents than Democrats or Republicans, I think we could help bring our politics back to the center. Second thing is redistricting reform. This is the one policy prescription. Mm. Sounds kind of wonky, but by having 96% of seats with no competitive general election, it's forced power to the margins from the center. It's enabled activists to control who's in Congress and empowered these folks to play only to the base instead of reaching out to the center. And then finally, I think it's just standing up to the extremes on both sides. Everyday folks calling out extremes on both sides instead of being dragged into this defense, de facto defense of their own party. It should be, you know, my country right or wrong, not my party right or wrong. And if more people do that, call out the extremes on both sides, I think we can start taking power back from the extremes and bring it back to the center.
All right. And you wouldn't say they're nutty on one side or the other. The extremes are just as nutty on both sides.
I think the far right and the far left can be equally insane.